physios, I welcome you all to our channel Physio Vidyapeeth. Today we will study about the therapeutic effects of the ultraviolet radiation. Along with this, we will try to add contraindication and danger in this video only, and in next video we will study about dosimetry, which is again a very very important part of your practical as well as theory examination. So my name is Vijay Kumar and let's start the topic. The first therapeutic effect is psoriasis. Okay, I have explained you this previously, but I will explain you again. Okay, first of all you need to understand that what happen in psoriasis. You can see in this diagram that these are the basal cells. Okay, these are the basal cells. These basal cells divide and reach up to the surface, and from surface they are shed off. And this process usually take about 28 or even up to 45 to 70 days. But in psoriasis, the cell turnover time, okay, this is the cell turnover time, that is we can say the cell move from basal layer to surface and shed off, this time get reduced and it become about 36 hours. Okay, so all these basal cells come and reach to the surface, come and reach to the surface like this. Okay, so this happens in the psoriasis. So it is in this, the epidermal transist time or the cell turnover, we can say, is which is 28 to 45 or even 75 days, is reduced to 36 hours. Okay, so time is reduced. It is manifested as silvery scales. Okay, these cells form a scale. Okay, this form a silvery scale which cover a pink or red plaque, and under the scale there is a pink or red plaque. Okay, there is increase in mitosis as you can see, and also there is a dilatation of capillary which cause the redness. Okay, and under the silvery scale you can see a pinpoint red color. Okay, like this, whenever you will remove this scale there will be a pinpoint, we can say dilated capillary. Okay, pinpoint dilated capillary. It is manifested as silvery scale covering the pink or red plaque. Okay, increase in mitosis and dilatation of capillary. Here UV are act as immunosuppressive. Okay, here the, we can say, immunosuppressive action is seen. Why? Because this psoriasis occurred due to a, we can say, a immunity. There is something wrong with the immunity. Okay, you can say. So here we need a immunosuppressive response which will cause the suppression in the DNA synthesis and further decrease in the proliferation of cells. Here UVA and UVB are used, not UVC is used. Okay, which is used? UVA and B is used, and it is used at E1 dose. It is used at E1 dose. Okay, I have written these things in brackets. Why? Because whenever you read psoriasis, you need to learn that there is UVA or B and at the E1 dose. Why? Because it is asked in the practical as it is, that in psoriasis you will use which type of UV and at which dose. Okay, I will explain the dose in next video. Okay, so this is, now there are three regimes. Okay, to apply the UV radiation in psoriasis, we can apply it by three regimes. The first is Zuckerman regime. Okay, it is Zuckerman regime. Application of coal tar 2 to 3 times a day. Okay, at the area of psoriasis, which can be any type of psoriasis, gutted psoriasis, and there are other also general form of psoriasis which you can study in pathology. Okay, so Zuckerman regime, in this there is an application of coal tar 2 to 3 times a day. So first of all we are going to apply coal tar 2 to 3 times a day, and then a general UVB is given once a day at E1 dose, that is minimal arrhythmal dose, or it is also called the subarrhythmal dose. Okay, simple, you can say that you are going to use coal tar 2 to 3 times, then UVB radiation. Okay, so Zuckerman regime use UVB radiation. In lead or in gram regime, here you are again giving the UVB radiation at MED after the coal tar bath. First of all the patient take a coal tar bath, then there is the general application of UVB. After that we are going to apply a cream which is dithranol. Let me correct the spelling, cover it by dithranol, D-I-T-H आर ए एन ओ एल डाइथेनॉल क्रीम विच इज अ वी कैन से एंटी सोरियाटिक क्रीम ओके विच इज देन रिमूव्ड ऑन द नेक्स्ट डे एंड अगेन वी आर गिविंग यूवीबी. सो देयर आर फोर स्टेप. फर्स्ट इज द कोल्टार बाथ. सेकेंड इज जनरल एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द आफ्टर टेकिंग कोल्टार बाथ देयर इज यूवीबी. फर्स्ट इज कोल्टार बाथ देन अगेन यूवीबी देन कवर इट बाय डाइथेनॉल क्रीम एंड नेक्स्ट डे आफ्टर रिमूविंग द क्रीम वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई यूवीबी दैट इज जनरल यूवीबी रेडिएशन. सो लीड एंड इनग्राम इज ऑल्सो यूजिंग यूवीबी. सो जुकरमैन एंड लीड एंड इनग्राम बोथ आर यूजिंग यूवीबी एंड कोल्टार एंड हियर जुकरमैन इन द जुकरमैन रेजिम वी आर यूजिंग इट वंस दैट इज यूवीबी इज यूज वंस एंड इन द लीड्स और इनग्राम रेजिम वी आर यूजिंग इट टू टाइम्स. फर्स्ट आफ्टर द कोल्टार बाथ सेकेंड आफ्टर रिमूविंग द डाइथेनॉल विच इज एन एंटी सोरियाटिक एजेंट ओके. एंड थर्ड रिजीम इज पोवा विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू. यूवीए इज गिवन टू आर आफ्टर सोलालिन इनटेक ओके. यू नो यूवीए ओनली यूवीए इज गिवन इन द पोवा प्रेटस एज इट इज नेम्ड सोरियासिस यूवीए एंड सोलालिन मेक द पर्सन सेंसिटिव टू यूवीए. सो एरिथमाइसिन सीनेट लो इंटेंसिटी दैट इज वी कैन यूज ईवन डोज एंड ट्रीटमेंट इज गिवन ट्वाइस अ डे एंड सोरियासिस कैन बी क्लियर इन 12 टू 18 exposures okay. So this is about the psoriasis. You need to focus on PUVA but you need to also understand the two regimes okay which are Zuckerman and lead or ingram regimes okay. Then acne vulgaris okay it is we can say a normal amount of acne is normal in the puberty but if it is excess it is a problematic and distressing condition. Inflammation of pilosebaceous unit. What does this mean pilosebaceous? It means the hair follicle along with its shaft and sebaceous gland. This is sebaceous gland okay. Here the inflammation occur usually at the chest, face or at the back. Sometimes it is coupled with the infection of acne bacillus okay. Important to be remember which form comedones. Comedones here comedones like this comedones are formed which are clump of keratin sebum and bacteria. So this comedone is filled with keratin sebum or bacteria also okay. Acne bulk acne bacillus okay acne bacillus I have written AB. Keratin sebum and acne bulgaris acne bacillus is the thing which is present in the comedones okay. Comedones here also we are using E2 dose okay. Acne vulgaris we are using slightly high dose which is E2 dose and what is the reason behind this? The reason behind this is that this E2 dose can cause peeling okay. So this comedone can be peeled off by the desquamization which can further open the block follicle. Why? Because the infection that is the bacteria cause the you can see I have written blocking of the follicles and when the skin is desquamized definitely the blocking is removed. Further there is the vasodilation and sterilization effect is also seen by UV radiation and as it can also kill the acne bacillus okay. So this is about the acne vulgaris. Simply saying you can write that here there is the we can say infection of the inflammation of pilosebaceous gland or the pilosebaceous unit you can say. That is sebaceous gland hair follicle along with its shaft and what is the reason? It is due to the infection of acne bacillus which form comedones which are clump of keratin sebum and bacteria which block the follicle okay. Which dose you are using? E2 dose either UVA or UVB can be used and how the therapeutic effect are there? Therapeutic effect is due to first vasodilation then due to sterilization effect that is killing of acne bacillus and third is due to the desquamization of skin which cause the opening of blocked follicles okay. So but you need to we can say understand one more thing that in acne vulgaris we can use the UVR treatment but it is not we can say that compatible. Why? Because there are a lot of side effects also so they are used but we can say not largely used okay. So you need to understand this also and rest all is complete about psoriasis and acne vulgaris. Now we will move toward the further therapeutic effect of UV radiations. our next therapeutic effect are eczema, chronic infection, vitiligo, treatment of vitamin D deficiency, protection of hypersensitive skin, then pruritus, hypertension and one psychological effect. Okay, these are very simple. Most important were psoriasis and acne vulgaris. Okay, so eczema, it is again we can say skin inflammation. It is an inflammation of skin which is associated with edema, redness and scaling. Okay, and simply we can use mild dose of UVR. Okay, like this you can write in bracket that you are going to use which dose of the UV radiation. Okay, then chronic infection. Okay, chronic infection, you can see that I have written UVC dose, UVC at E4 dose is used. It includes the infection of open wound such as pressure sores. Here E4 dose is used, which is applied by Cromer lab. And why we are using E4 dose? Why? Because as you know that at E4 dose also the UVC is germicidal. Okay, reason is that why are we using UVC? What is the question? Question is that why are we using UVC? Because there is infection of open wound na, and in the classification I have written that UVC is germicidal, so it can kill the bacteria that has infected our wound. But in case of non-infected wound, we are going to use UVA, which can stimulate the granulation tissue formation, further accelerate the healing and growth. Okay, so it is about the chronic infection. More we can say important is this infected wound. Okay, in which we are using E4 dose of UVC. Then vitiligo is, you can say that, I can explain you that this is our surface layer of skin and inside there are cells which are melanocytes, and these melanocytes are going to produce the pigment which is melanin. But if due to any reason these melanocytes are, we can say, less due to their destruction, then there are white patches on the skin which is called vitiligo. Okay, it is an autoimmune disease, that is in which there is a destruction of melanocyte which help in the formation of melanin, and if it is absent it causes the white patches. Both UVA and B can be used, but here UVA is more used. Why? Because we know that it produces more or better pigmentation, and if B is used it can also cause thickening, because UVB is more for thickening and A is for pigmentation. Along with this we can use topical glucocorticoid or soraline, that is PUVA is also used. So there can be a tricky VIPA question that name the give the two use of PUVA. One, you know that in the psoriasis, second is in the vitiligo. Okay, where we are using the topical soraline. Okay, topical soraline UVA is also effective. Then in the treatment of vitamin D deficiency, it is simple. In the UV rays help in conversion of the 7-dehydrocholesterol to vitamin D. It is converted by UVB and UVC, and here we are using subarachnoid dose. Okay, don't confuse about the doses. I will explain the dosimetry to you in the next video. So all these things will be perfectly crystal clear in your mind. Okay, subarachnoid dose is used and it help in prevention of rickets, osteomalacia and osteoporosis, which is very simple. Then protection of hypersensitivity skin. Yes, there are some, we can say, person who are working in high sunshine and there are chances of skin burn. So if we are giving UVB radiation, the we can say chances are reduced. Okay, chances are reduced. Here also we are using UVB. Then pruritus, serious itching. It is a serious itching which is due to the increased bile acid level. Why bile acid are increasing? Bile acid are increasing due to biliary chirrhosis, or also it can be due to the chronic renal failure. You can use subarachnoid dose on the whole body. Okay, you can see on the whole body or in combination of cholestyramine. Okay, so you need to remember this drug also, that to treat pruritus you can either use the UVB as the on the whole body at subarachnoid dose, or you can do this along with the drug cholestyramide. Then hypertension, it is simple, UVBS subarachnoid dose is used. Calcium regulatory hormone, we are associated with increased production of vitamin D, which helps in regulation of BP. Then psychological effect, some individual use it for tanning, which give a better look. Okay, so this is whole about the therapeutic effect of the ultraviolet radiation, and now we will directly move toward the contraindications and dangers, and in the next video we will study about dosimetry. Now we will study about the contraindication, precautions and danger of ultraviolet radiation. Okay, so contraindication, first is irradiation of eyes. Yes, it is quite normal that whenever UV radiation is, we can say, applied at eye, it can cause damage. That is, it can cause photokeratitis, okay, and also cause damage to cornea and lens. In lens, it can cause cataract. And you need to remember that UVA is absorbed in lens, while B and C is absorbed in the cornea. Then skin cancer, yes. If there is already a skin cancer, okay, and we are giving the ultraviolet radiation, it can further cause mutations and further increase our problem. So we are not going to apply ultraviolet radiation in skin cancer patient. Similarly, in pulmonary tuberculosis, it can exacerbate the symptoms, okay. So we are not going to apply the radiation. Then systemic lupus erythematosus, it is important. It is a autoimmune disease in which there is the degeneration of our connective tissue, and connective tissue can either be musculoskeletal, neural, renal or skin. Okay, so here also we are not going to apply the ultraviolet radiation. And fever in the patients who are febrile, we are not going to apply the ultraviolet radiation. Okay, then precautions, with the patient taking photosensitizing medication. Okay, yes, for example, antibiotics or medicine which have gold also, okay, gold based medicine, then sulfonamide, tetracycline, quinolones, etc. Okay, why? Because they are sensitizing the individual for UVs, okay, and they cause decrease in minimal erythematous dose and cause burns. Okay, so you need to be take a precaution. Okay, so then in photosensitivity, same, fair color individual or the individual who are having naturally red hair, okay, they are at lower level of irradiation. Okay, so we are going to give the UV radiation to them, but at a low dosage. Okay, recent X-ray therapy, it can cause malignancy because the patient are prone to malignancy if we are applying the ultraviolet radiation. Then until the effect of prior doses disappear, okay, to minimize the effect of or the risk of burn, okay, to prevent the burn. So these are the general precautions. Then danger, it can cause burn at high doses. Premature skin aging, I have explained you in the chronic long-term physiological effect. Then carcinogenesis, prolonged exposure can carcinogenesis, again physiological effect are repeating. Then damage to eye, yes, the patient as well as the therapist are going to wear goggles. And in case of PUVA pretus or PUVA treatment, the patient is going to wear goggles even after 12 hours after taking the soralene. Okay, why? Because for that 12 hours, he is very sensitive for UV radiation and that can cause damage to its eye. Okay, then adverse effect due to PUVA, it can cause nausea, vomiting after taking soralene, and prolonged exposure can cause malignancy as discussed earlier. Okay, so this was a very simple part, okay, in which we discussed about therapeutic effect. Psoriasis and acne vulgaris are very important, and then these are, you can say, very simple contraindication, precaution and danger. So with this we finish off this topic, but in the next video we are going to study about the dosimetry or dosage of ultraviolet radiation, which is again important. Till then, you keep on studying. Thank you to one and all.